to understand the way I am, mein Herr.
Lainie, you have a very unique history with Bob Fosse Choreography and with the Fosse Estate. Can you share that with us?
The first time I saw Bob Fosse's work, I was a little kid. So I used to be this lonely kid that would watch movie musicals on the weekends on Saturdays by myself. And I'd watch every single movie musical. I don't know if there's one that I haven't seen. And his work in Pajama Game, in Damn Yankees, My Sister Eileen, oh, and Sweet Charity. Those are the four, I think, even as a kid, I really connected with, and I love that work. When I started work on Fosse Choreography, it was actually in 1994. I was picked out of a Broadway show. Chet Walker saw me in a Broadway show and invited me to these special invited classes we had in New York. And the reason we had these special secret classes is because Gwen Verdon at the time was convinced that no one could really do the Fosse's work anymore, that my generation of dancers couldn't do it. So Chet Walker and Gwen would have these private classes. You'd get a phone call and you were invited to come and you would do one piece of vocabulary over and over again for maybe 90 minutes, or we would reconstruct a combination of it, and Gwen would be right next to me in a leotard and tights warming up just like everybody else, and we'd work once a week, then twice a week, then three times a week. And over this time, eventually we had our first workshop with Live Ent in 1996, and from the very first workshop I was asked to be, at the time, dance captain and assistant to Chet Walker. And so my history with the Fosse work was from actually the very beginning. And then when we moved to Broadway, I was one of the three people from the creative team that actually continued to move on with the Broadway company to reconstruct all of his works.
Lainie, why do you think Bob Fosse's choreographic style is so closely tied to Cabaret when he never actually choreographed a stage version of the musical?
The way Bob Fosse approaches choreography and the work and his point of view as far as his ideas of storytelling, I think connects greatly to the musical Cabaret in maybe more ways than other choreographers. And it is because of the subject matter. I think that when we use Fosse, it's maybe the best in musicals where you feel like there's the cracks in the armor, that there's something always going on underneath. There's always subtext, I should say, in all of his work. So that's why it's hard, because the artists that you ask to do this work, the dancers, the performers that do this, have to understand how to do that. And there's a certain level of trust, because I think as performers, you know, you're more of an extrovert on stage and you wanna like throw all your talent on the stage and really like look at all of this. But in his work, you have to really pull back and trust it and really understand that all of that is seen, that it's all layered and underneath. And so we used to always say, instead of like a performer smiling and like, love me, love me, love me, that the smiles more the subtext is, I have a secret. And so there's always something going on underneath. So the style is very specific, it's smaller, and it has a kind of unlawful quality to it, which I think works very well with this musical.
The song Mein Herr was written for the movie, but appears in this version of the stage musical. And you're going to use that song to pay a very special tribute to Bob Fosse, correct?
I had this really great conversation with Nicole Fosse, and we collaborated on something where she said she wanted me to take my Fosse knowledge and then to go ahead and infuse my own choreography with it, to make it something modern and relevant. And I think that for Cabaret, that's how I connect Mein Herr, which I'm doing as, you know, the homage. I'm recreating Mein Herr as Bob intended from the movie.
Bye-bye, my lieber Herr. Farewell, my lieber Herr. It was a fine affair, but now it's over. And though I used to care, I need the open air. You're better off without me. You'll get on without me.
But I think what's interesting about me as a choreographer for this production of Goodspeed is I have all of this knowledge. So even though the rest of the numbers is not Bob Fosse's numbers, I can't help it. It's kind of infused in me as an artist because of all the time that I've spent with it. So now I get to take what I've always have known and learned, and it's part of the kind of underneath living in the choreography that I give you today.